it has a big train crash. And that was achieved by actually crashing a train. And that turned out to be the best way to do it. We were in the mountains in North Carolina in the winter, awful cold, and there was a railroad which ran in the summer there as a sort of tourist railroad. It must once have had some industrial function, but now, and for many years, it had been simply a tourist railroad to take people to the Smoky Mountains or whatever the hell they are. And in the winter, it wasn't used, and so that we rented an engine and some cars and a section of track and crashed the train. And I presumably they built a new engine or whatever they did. I don't know. We would have left and gone back to Chicago by then, so I don't know. But well, the big secret of how we did it was we just crashed a train and filmed it with a lot of cameras. And
it's an amazing sequence.
Correctly, yeah, it is. But it turned out that the best thing to do was not to do digital anything, was just to crash a train, and we crashed a train. We had a lot of cameras and turned them all on and lit it well and crashed the train. And there's some other, there is some stuff actually that that we matted in with Harrison running and things, but a lot of that even is, we shot Harrison and we shot where he's running and the train is going behind him and everything. We didn't, obviously you can't threaten the big movie star with that, so that was composited later. But most of it, we just plain crashed the train and shot it. There's some nice stuff in it. There's nice examples of, I did that once and I was talking at some, God knows why. After you get to a certain age, you spend most of your time talking instead of doing, but I was trying to give examples of the two poles that I was talking about earlier of documentary and theatrical lighting, and I used that movie because there's that sequence where they sneak up on a house in the slums of Chicago, which is done without any lights, without anything, and mostly handheld, and just sees them coming in and going into the house. And it's done utterly documentary, and it looks, I think it works very successfully as these agents sneaking up on a beat-up house in a bad section of Chicago, and it's quite thoroughly documentary without any embellishment of any kind. And in the same movie, there is the opposite end. There's a sequence where Tommy Lee Jones and the other guys hunt Harrison through a series of sewers underneath a tunnel that leads to a bridge. I mean, it's all made up, it's all nonsense. But I don't know if you remember, but there's, you know, they go through a whole series of tunnels and there's water pouring down and they slide on this and that. And in fact, there is, if it were a real place, there would be no light at all. Yeah. Because it's underneath a road, which is in a tunnel. So it's, so there's no light, you know. But of course you can't have a movie if there's no light. So I took big lights and I would shine them straight down through various holes as if for some reason, instead of being underneath a road in a tunnel, they were outside. And so there'd be a shaft of light here that would miraculously happen to aim just where you needed it to aim. And that was the other, and there'd be no other light, maybe a tiny bit of fill light, but probably not. And that was all built, that set of tunnels was all built on a stage in some big warehouse in Chicago. And we built sort of tracks underneath the water so we could dolly along here and there. And I had a small amount of fill light on the front of the dolly, maybe. But basically, it would be just dark, and then there'd be these big shafts of light. And those shafts of light are the opposite of documentary. They are that basic theatricality of telling you where to look, like, you know, and where to look happened to be where Tommy Lee Jones or Harrison Ford was. But it works. And then he jumps off a fake dam, top of a dam, and we dropped a dummy in front of a huge real dam in North Carolina. And there you are. It all works. Anyway, the two poles of cinematography are both happened to be in that one movie, and I was using it in some film festival or something I was talking about. I don't know. But it's an amusing movie. It's fun, I thought. The Fugitive, sort of silly, but nice. And it works, I guess. It seemed, made a lot of money anyway. And got me an Academy Award nomination again. So who am I to know? And all the time I bitched and complained and said I hated being there and I was the wrong guy and then cursed and this and that. And it all worked out. So, you know, you never know. You really do never know. Never, never know. Never have any idea. Even back, way back to Godfather, we had no idea. No idea in the world. Francis almost got fired. It went way over budget. There were all conspiracies and this and that going on. And look at what happened, you know? So nobody, all that old cliche, nobody knows anything is entirely true. Nobody knows anything, just about.